Hi everyone. Today we are going to talk about something that comes up often in estate planning, family feuds. You may wonder why you should care if your family fights since you will no longer be there. Well, you may have a spouse that needs access to the money to pay for daily expenses, or you may know that one particular child is very aggressive and defiant, so you want to ensure things are peacefully process during this difficult time. For whatever reason, it is always a good idea to address this before it is actually an issue. I'm Raluca Hania. I offer estate planning, family law, and immigration services to my clients. I'm here with my office and marketing manager, Nina Clear. And thank you for your likes, shares, and comments as always. And we really appreciate all your support.
So we don't want family fighting?
No.
So it seems like the first thing you could do is just not tell your family who you're leaving what.
That's true. But like I mentioned before, this is just putting off the inevitable.
What do you mean by that?
Well, if you think people are going to be upset by your decisions, they're going to be upset whether you are here or not. But if you have a spouse or a child who needs money to live on, you don't want to make it so that the money are tied up in court fights. You may want to take other steps to stop the fighting.
So what do you suggest?
The first thing I recommend is to have people meet with whomever they are leaving things to in their will with an attorney. Many times people will fight because they don't know or don't understand what is happening. So having a knowledgeable professional answer questions might remove any arguments that would have taken place.
Okay, that's a great idea. What else could they do?
Another idea is to make a non-interested person executor of the estate, as well as having only one executor.
What does that mean?
An executor is also known as a personal representative here in Georgia. They are the person who makes sure that the wishes of the person whose will it is are carried out. If you put, say, your children in charge of your estate and they all fight with each other about it, that is not the best idea. If you put one person in charge, especially one who doesn't have an interest in what happens beyond making sure your wishes are carried out, that may reduce fights.
Okay, so how else can you end fights before they start?
Another way is to be very specific in your will, especially if you have told someone you will leave them something.
Can you give us an example?
Sure. If you have told your daughter since she was little that she would get all your jewelry, put that in your will.
Well, what might happen if you don't?
If you don't, the jewelry may be sold or distributed equally amongst all the beneficiaries, depending on how the will is written.
Anything else?
Yes. If you know a person might have mental health or addiction problems, you may want to assign a trustee to any distribution that would go to them.
And how does that help?
This will help them, hopefully, to use the assets in a wiser way for living expenses.
Okay, any other tips?
Yes, keep your documents up to date. Don't let your will sit around for 25 years with no changes, because chances are things have changed in your life and finances. You may have new family members, such as grandchildren, or people who have died and shouldn't be in the will any longer.
Is there any way to write in your will that people who fight don't get anything?
Yes, you can. And it is called a no contest clause, also called an interorum clause. And if people fight, that people fight about what the will gives them, Georgia courts have upheld these clauses so that people receive nothing. And sometimes they will have to pay attorney fees to anyone who had to fight their position. You, in making some decisions in your will, I want everyone to remember stuff is just stuff. People, family, and relationships are what matters. I hope that people wouldn't fight with their family about belongings, but since it does happen, use these tips to help keep them to a minimum. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.